Hi students, it is your combination class, concept class. Do you know, I think, about your permutation? Permutations means arrangement, but here combination means selection. We have to learn what is the difference between permutation and combination. In which question we apply the permutation formula, in which question we apply our combination formula. Clear? It is the first things we have to know. Second things, when we solve the combinations questions, there are different types of logics. In which logics we apply which tricks to find the question's answer immediately. That means maximum to maximum 10 seconds to 15 seconds, how do we solve the question, okay? Combination, suppose permutation and a combination, at first we have to learn the difference between permutation and a combination. Permutation means arrangement. Permutation, arrangement. And a combination, selection. Permutation, arrangement, combination, selection. There are six, there are 3 points. These are the 3 points. We can make a triangle using these 3 points. How many triangles we can be formed? That is your one triangle. We can be formed one triangle using these 3 digits. So this is a first, sorry, this the 3 points. This is your first point, second point, and third point. How many triangles we can be formed using these 3 points? That is your one triangle. One triangle. These points are A, B, C. When we say the name of the triangle, name of the triangle means I can write ABC triangle, then ACB triangle, then BCA triangle, then BAC triangle, then CBA triangle, then CAB triangle. There are 6 ways we can express the name of the triangle. But using these 3 points, we can arrange, we can select, we can make one triangle. This one triangle, it is your combination. And the name of the triangle, it is your permutation. Okay? So here, how many triangles we can be formed using the 3 points such as ABC? That is your one triangle. Another question, how many triangles we can be formed using the 4 points? Using these 4 points, how many triangles we can be formed using these 4 points? So here, for C3, there are 4 points. We select 3 points at a time. We select 3 points at a time. When you select 3 points, you can make one triangle. That is your 4C3. 4C3 means, you know that NCR combination, N factorial divided by R factorial whole into N minus R factorial. So 4C3 means 4 factorial divided by 3 factorial. 4 minus 3, it is your 1 factorial. 4 factorial divided by 3 factorial, that is your 4 into 3 factorial divided by 3 factorial. 3 factorial, 3 factorial cancels, then we get 4. there are four triangles which can be formed using these points. Are you clear? How many triangles we can be formed using these three points, using these four points? There are four triangles you can be formed using these four points. In the three points, when you select three points, okay, we can make one triangle. When you select three points, we can make one triangle. In each three points, one triangle, it is your combination, we select. But in this case, only we arrange the name of the letter, ABC, CBA, then BAC, okay. This is your permutation and this is your combination. Suppose another example, there are 5 persons, there are 15 persons, 15 persons. We can make a group, many groups, we can make groups. In each group, we give 5 persons, in each group, we give 5 persons. When you take 5 persons, then you can make a group. Clear? So here 15 persons. In each 5 persons, it is a group. How many groups we can be formed using the 15 persons? Okay? How many groups we can be arranged by 15 persons? In each group, there are 5 persons including. Clear? In each group, there are 5 persons. How many groups we can be arranged? In 15 persons. So I write here 15C5. There are 15 persons. We select only 5 persons. When we select the 5 persons, we can make a group. These 5 persons indicates to one group. 15C5 means NCR. This formula, N factorial divided by R factorial whole into N minus R factorial. In the case of NPR, this is your N factorial divided by N minus R factorial. Okay. NPR, in case of NPR, N factorial divided by N minus R factorial. But NCR, N factorial divided by R factorial whole into N minus R factorial. 15C5 means 15 factorial divided by 5 factorial, 15 minus 5 factorial. So 15 factorial divided by 5 factorial into 10 factorial. So 15 into 14 into 13 into 12 into 11 into 10 factorial divided by 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 into 10 factorial. So 10 factorial cancels. 5 3 are 15, 15 cancels. Then 4 3 are 12, okay. 2 7 are, then we multiplied here 7 into 13 into 3 into 11. 13 7 are 91 into 3 into 11. 3 1 are 3, 3 9 are 27 into 11. 11 3 are 33, 33 carry. 11 7 are 77 plus 3, 80, 0, 80 carry. 11 2 are 22 plus 8, 30. 22 plus 8, 30. 3 0 0, 3. Clear. In another way, suppose there are 15 persons. There are 15 persons. They shake hand each other. How many handshakes we get from the 15 persons in a party? There are 15 persons. They shake hand each other. How many handshakes we get? So here, for the one handshake, we need only 2 persons. For one handshake, we need only 2 persons. So there are 15 persons. In the 2 persons, we make a handshake. So that 15C2. 15C2 means in each 2 person, in 2 persons, we get only one handshake. So I write 15C2, 15 factorial divided by 2 factorial into 15 minus 2 factorial. So I write 15 factorial divided by 2 factorial into 13 factorial. That means 15 into 14 into 13 factorial divided by 2 into 13 factorial. 13 factorial cancels 2 7 ja, 15 7 ja, 105. So 105 handshake we get. Clear? Suppose another example. How many diagonals we can be formed from an octagon? This is your question. How many diagonals we can be formed from an octagon? Suppose another example, it is a rectangle. Okay. In the rectangle, there are two diagonals. A, B, C, D. The two diagonals are AC and BD. These are the two diagonals, AC and BD. So here, when you see this rectangle, you know that these are the two diagonals, then answer will be 2. From an octagon, how many diagonals we get? So here, for the one diagonal, we need 2 points. For the one diagonal, we need 2 points. And from the one side, also we need 2 points. Okay. For the one diagonal, we need 2 points. And one side, it is only 2 points. And this diagonal also need 2 points. For each diagonal, we need 2 points, and each side also we need 2 points. So here there are total how many points here? 4 points. Number of sides and diagonal both 4c2. Number of sides plus number of diagonals, it is your 4c2. 4c2 means 4 factorial divided by 2 factorial into 2 factorial. 4 factorial means 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, and it is your 2 factorial. 2 factorial means 2 into 2. 2 to ja 4, 4 cancels. This is your 3 to ja 6. Okay. 3 to ja 6. Okay. 6 is diagonals plus sides is equal to 6. So there are how many sides here? 4 sides. In a rectangle, there are 4 sides. If the side number of sides is 4 is equal to 6, then find the value of the D. D value here 2. D value here. So for the another example. In a party, there are 28 handshakes. Find the persons present in that party. This is the question. Number of handshakes given. But questions to us, find the number of persons present in that party. You know that in each 2 persons, we get only 1 handshake. So that number of persons here n, number of persons, we assume this n. According to the question, NC2 is equal to 28. You know that n into n minus 1 factorial divided by n into n minus 1 divided by 2. N into n minus 1 divided by 2 is equal to 28. This is your 28. Then n into n minus 1 is equal to 56. These two numbers are consecutive numbers. Which product is 56? That number is what? 8 and 7. 8, 7 is 56. N minus 1, it is 7. Okay. The number of persons present in that party, there are 8 persons. So that option, Eight is your answer. You have to choose from the options which answer is your correct. Come to the next number. These are the examples. What we learn now, we apply this fundamental tricks NCR in this question. There are 10 oranges in a basket. Find the number of oranges in which 3 oranges are chosen from the basket. There are 10 oranges. 10 oranges. We select only 3 oranges. In 3 oranges, when we select 3 oranges, we make a group. How many ways we can select 3 oranges? How many times we can select 3 oranges from the 10 oranges? This is your 10C3. 10C3 means NCR. NCR, N factorial divided by R factorial whole into N minus R factorial. But in the case of NPR, N factorial divided by N minus R factorial. In the NPR, it is your N factorial divided by only N minus R factorial. But in the case of NCR, N factorial divided by R factorial whole into N minus R factorial. If you observe these two formulas, in the first formula, in denominator only N minus R factorial. But in the case of a combination, R factorial into N minus R factorial in the denominator. Okay. Then 10 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 7 factorial. 10 minus 3, 7 factorial. 10 into 9 into 8 into 7 factorial divided by 3 into 2 into 1 into 7 factorial. This is 7 factorial, 7 factorial cancels. 3, 3 is 90, 2, 4 is 8, 4, 3 is 12, 12, 10 is 120. So that option D is your correct answer. 120 ways we can select 3 oranges from the 10 oranges. Suppose another example. In a class, there are 10 boys students and 10 girl students. Okay. There are 10 boys and 10 girls in a class. We can make a team. In that team, 3 boys and 2 girls included. Okay, clear what I said? Again, listen to my question. There are 10 boys and 10 girls in a class. We can select 5 students. We can select 5 students in which 3 boys and 2 girls are included. Clear? So 3 boys and 2 girls are included. We can make the 5 persons group. We can make 5 PE students group. So 10C3 into 10C2. Okay. 10C3 into 10C2. So 10C3 means 10 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 7 factorial. And 10C2 means 10 factorial divided by 10C3 into 10C2. 10 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 7 factorial. 2 factorial into 8 factorial. So 10C3 means 10 into 9 into 8 into 7 factorial divided by 3 into 2 into 1 into 7 factorial. This is the cancels. 3, 3 ja 9, 2, 4 ja, 4, 3, 12 ja, 100, 20. So here 10C2 means 10 into 9 divided by 2. So 2, 5 ja, 9, 5 ja, 45. So 0, 12, 5 ja, 60, 0, 6 carry, 12, 4 ja, 80, 48, 6, 54. 5,400 ways we can make a group. In that group, we can select only 5 persons, in which 5 persons, 3 persons are boys and 2 persons are girls. Clear what I say? Question number 2. Find the number of triangles formed by joining the vertex of septagon. Joining the vertex of septagon, of one septagon. In the septagon, we can make the triangle. There are 7 vertex of the septagon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is your septagon. This is the septagon. Clear? But we can make the triangle. There are 7 points, 7 vertex. For the one triangle, we select only 3 points. so that 7c3 means 7 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 7 minus 3, 4 factorial. So I write here 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 factorial divided by 3 into 2 into 1 into 4 factorial. This 4 factorial cancels. 3 to 6, 6 cancels. 7, 5 is 35. So option B is your correct answer. Clear? Question number 2, answer B. Then come to the next number. Find the number of diagonals of a septagon. Find the number of diagonals of a septagon. You know that in the septagon, the number of vertex are 7. So, for the diagonals, I write here 7C2. 7C2 means 7 into 6 divided by 2. 2, 3 is 7, 3 is 21. From the 21, 7 lines are side of the septagon. Minus 7. 21 minus 7 is equal to 14. Option B is your correct answer. Option B is your correct answer. So, suppose I write for an example 10C2. 10C2 means 10 factorial divided by 2 factorial into 10 minus 2, 8 factorial. Then you can write 10 into 9 into 8 factorial divided by 2 into 8 factorial. This 8 factorial cancel. We get 10 into 9 by 2. We get 10 into 9 by 2. 10 into 9 by 2 means 2, 5 is a 9, 5 is a 45. Then finally, last we get 10 into 9 by 2. 10C2, directly you can write 10C2, this number is 10 and that previous number is 9 divided by 2. Suppose 11C2, what I write here? 11 into 10 divided by 2. Then suppose 14C2, what I write? 14 into 13 divided by 2. Suppose 15C2, I write here 15 into 14 divided by 2. When two consecutive numbers are in the denominator 15, 14, this is the consecutive number. In the two consecutive number, definitely you will get one even number and one odd number. So divided by 2 means this even number in the numerator completely divisible by 2. Okay, clear? Suppose another example, there are 11 points. There are 11 points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. These are the 11 points. How many straight lines we can we form? No, 3 points are collinear. That means in one straight line we cannot, get 3 points. No, 3 points are collinear. There are 10 points, 11 points. There are 11 points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10, 11. Okay, 11 points. We can make how many straight lines? So, for one straight line, we need only 2 points. No, 3 points are collinear. So, that is your 11C2. 11C2 means 11 into 10 divided by 2. 2, 5 is a, 11, 5 is a, 55. So, 55 straight lines we can make using the 11 points. No, 3 points are collinear. Clear? Come to the next example. Question number 4. Find the number of diagonals of an octagon. So, here, octagon means there are 8 points, 8 vertex. Number of diagonals 8C2 minus 8. Minus 8 means in the octagon there are 8 sides. We subtract 8 sides from the 8C2. Because in the 8C2, number of sides and number of diagonals both are included. So 8C2 means 8 into 7 divided by 2 minus 8. Then 2, 4 is 7 4 जा 28 minus 8 is equal to 20. So option 20, none of these E is your correct answer. Question 4 answer E. Next number, question number 5. In a party, every person shakes hands with every other person. If there was a total of 45 handshakes in the party, find the number of persons who are present in the party. Here, number of handshake, what? 45. You know that in two persons, in each two persons, we get only one handshake. For one handshake, we need or we require only two persons. Without two persons, we cannot make only one handshake. For only one handshake, we need two persons. So that number of persons here n, nc2 is equal to 45. nc2 means you know that 1 is n, then another is n minus 1 divided by 2 is equal to 45. So n into n minus 1 is equal to 45 into 2 is equal to 90. There are two consecutive numbers which product is 90. There are two consecutive numbers which product is 90. N into n minus 1 is equal to 90. 10 into 9 is equal to 90. So number of number of persons present in that party, that is your 10. Option B is your correct answer. Question number 5 answer. Question number 6. There are 5 members in a delegation which is to be sent abroad. The total number of members is 10. But we select only 5 members. Clear? In how many ways can the selection be made so that a particular member is always in the case of included and double I in the case of excluded? So that a member is always included and excluded. There are 10 members. One member is selected for each group. The person who is selected for each group, that is only one person. The rest number of members are 9. From the 10 persons, one person is selecting for all the groups. This one person is going in each group, that is your one. In the case of included, the rest persons are 9. So 9c4 into 1c1. So 9c4 means 9 factorial divided by 4 factorial into 5 factorial. So I can write 9 into 8 into 7 into 6 divided by 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. In 5 factorial. This 5 factorial cancels. 3 to 6, 6 cancels. 4 to 8. Okay, 4 to 8. So 7 to 9 into 7 to 14. 9 for the 36, 63 carry. 9 1 9, 3, 12. 126. In the case of included, the answer is what? 126. Clear? In the case of excluded, suppose there are 10 persons, 5 persons are selecting for the abroad. So, 1 person from the 10 person, 1 person is not going in each group. 1 person is not selecting for each group. So, that 1 person is excluded. The rest of persons are 9. From the 9 persons, we select only 5 persons which is going to abroad. So that 9c5 means 9 factorial divided by 5 factorial into 4 factorial. So I write 9 into 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 factorial divided by 5 factorial into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. This 5 factorial cancels. 4 to 8, 3 to 6, 6 cancels. 7 to 14, 9 ja 126, 14, 9 ja 14, 9 ja 126. In the case of included, 126 answer is 126. and in the case of excluded also answer 126. Clear? Option E is our correct answer. Come to the next number, question number 7. There are 8 points in a plane, out of which 6 are collinear. How many points are collinear? 6 are collinear. There are 18 points in a plane, out of which 6 points are collinear. Find the number of triangles formed by the points as vertex. Okay, clear? So, 18 points, how many triangles we can be formed? 18, see 3. And from the 18, 6 points are collinear. When the 6 points are collinear in one straight line, there are 6 points. We cannot make the triangle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We cannot make the triangle. But these points are helps to make another triangle. But these points are not eligible to make triangle among each other. So that this point helps to another point to make a triangle. That is your 18C3 minus 6C3. Minus 6C3. Okay. But you can write here 18 minus 6 means 12C3. It is wrong answer. Because 6 points are collinear. In the collinear points, we cannot make the triangle. 18 minus 6 is equal to 12. By this 12 points, we can make the triangle. That is your 12C3. It is a completely wrong answer. This point cannot make triangle among each 6C points, because these 6 points are collinear, but this point helps to the another point which is not collinear to make a triangle. Clear what I say here? So answer here 18C3 minus 6C3. 18C3 means 18 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 15 factorial. Minus 6C3 means 6 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 3 factorial. So 18 into 17 into 16 divided by 3 into 2 into 1 minus 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 factorial divided by 3 into 2 into 1 into 3 factorial. So 3 factorial, 3 factorial cancel, 3 to 6, 6 cancels, 5 4 are 20. Then here 3 2 is 6, 6 3 is 18, 17 3 is 51, 51 into 16 minus 20, 51 into 16, 16 1 is 16, 6 1 carry, 16 5 is 80 plus 1, 81, 800 16 minus 20. So I write here 6, 11 minus 2 is equal to 9, then 7, 796. Option B is your correct answer. Okay, clear? Come to the next number, question number 8. There are 13 points in a plane, out of which 4 are collinear. There are 13 points in a plane, out of which 4 are collinear. Find the number of straight lines formed by joining them. How many points? 13 points. 4 points are collinear. So I write 13C2. What I write here? Why I write here 2? Why I write 2? 13C2, because for a straight line we only need 2 points. In 2 points we can make a straight line. There are 13 points. How many straight lines we can be formed? That is your 13C2. 13C2 minus 4C2 minus 4C2 plus 1. These 4 points are not using to make a single straight line. Single straight line means, suppose I give the name of these points A, B, C, D. So A, B is a straight line, and A, C, if A, B, C, then A, B is a straight line, A, C is a straight line. Okay. Then B, C is a straight line. There are 3 straight lines which can be formed. But in this case, only one straight line possible. Only one straight line possible. So I write here 1 plus 1. 13C2 minus 4C2 plus 1. This is 13C2 minus 4C2 plus 1. 13C2 means 13 into 12 divided by 2 minus 4 into 3 divided by 2 plus 1. Then 2 6 is 13 6 is 78 minus 2 2 is 2 3 is 6 plus 1. 78 minus 6 is 72 plus 1. It is your 73. Option A is your correct answer. Question number 8, answer A. Then next number. On a New Year day, every student of a class sends a card to every other student. The postman delivers 1190 cards. How many students are there in the class? Very interesting question. For a handshake, we need only 2 persons. Okay. Without 2 persons, we cannot make a handshake. Clear? For a letter, we only need 2 persons. Without 2 persons, you cannot give a letter. If you want to give a letter, that means we require only 2 persons. In the case of handshake, by the 2 persons, you can make only 1 handshake. But in the case of letter, you give your letter to your friend and your friend also give you a letter. Are you clear what I say? Suppose there are 2 persons, you and your friend. You give a letter to your friend and your friend give a letter to you. But 2 persons, in these 2 persons, we can send 2 letters. But in the case of handshake, in the 2 persons, we can only make a handshake, a single handshake. But in the case of letter, you can make 2 letters between the 2 students. But 2 friends, sorry, 2 friends. But in the case of handshake, you can make only 1 handshake between 2 friends. Are you clear what I say? For the 1 letter, but we require only 2 persons. That is your MC2. Each person, the postman delivers 1190 cards. On a New Year day, every student of a class sends a card to every other student. Every student of a class sends a card to every other student. They send each other. Clear? So NC2, 2 into NC2. Why you multiplied here 2? Because they send each other. 2 into NC2 is equal to 1190. Then NC2 is equal to 1190 by 2. Then NC2 means N into N minus 1 divided by 2 is equal to 1190 divided by 2. 2 cancels. N into N minus 1 is equal to 1190. So here 7, 1 the 7, 170. Then if you 5, 2 ja, 5, 3 ja, 15, 4, then 17, then 2. So here 7, 5 ja, 35, then 7, 2 ja, 34. These are the 2 numbers. 35 into 34 is equal to 1190. Don't go to the quadratic equation form n square minus n minus 1190 is equal to 0. Don't try to solve this question in this way. Okay. But it is the basic solution, basic calculation. The 2 numbers, which is consecutive numbers, the 2 numbers n and n minus 1, both are the consecutive numbers. This product is 1190. So you write here 35 and 34 is equal to 1190. Clear? The number of persons here 35. Option A is your correct answer. Question number 10. In an examination, a minimum is to be secured in each of 6 subjects for a pass. In how many ways can a student fail? I will give you another example. Suppose you appear IBPS PO exam, IBPS PO pre-exam. There are 3 subjects, aptitude, reasoning, and English. Then question, in how many ways a student can be failed? In how many ways a student can be failed? Suppose fail, fail, fail. One way is fail, pass, fail. Then fail, fail, pass. Then fail, pass, pass. then fell, fell, pass. Then pass, pass, fell. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then pass, fell, pass. 7. Pass, fell, fell, fell. Fell, pass, fell. Fell, fell, pass. Then pass, pass, fell. Then pass, fell, fell. Then fail, pass, pass, fail. Then fail, fail, pass. Okay? Fail, fail, pass. Then finally pass, pass, pass. Clear? These are the 8 ways students' result we declare. And in the 7 ways a student we failed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The 7 ways a student will be failed. This shortcut, there are 3 subjects. In how many times he will be failed in one subject, that is your 3C1 plus 3C2 plus 3C3. 3C1 means it is your 3, because 4C1 it is 4. How is it possible? 4 factorial divided by 4, 1 factorial, 4 minus 1, 3 factorial. 4 into 3 factorial divided by 3 factorial. 3 factorial cancelled, it is your 4. Just think 3C1, 3 factorial divided by 1 factorial into 3 minus 1, 2 factorial. 3 into 2 factorial divided by 2 factorial cancels 2 factorial, 2 factorial. So you get 3. 3C2. 3C2 means 3, it is C. Next number 2 divided by 2, 2, 2 cancels, it is 3. 3C1, 1. 3, 3, 6, 1, 7. In 7 ways, a student can be failed. Then, how we solve this question in the shortcut way? The shortcut way is, how many subjects here? There are 3 subjects here. So, the result will be declared 2 to the power 3. The result will be declared 2 to the power 3. 2 to the power 3. 2 to the power 3 means 8 ways the result will be declared. But a student can be failed minus 1. 8 minus 1 is equal to 7. This 1 is the pass. Chances. Pass, 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 pass. This 1 for pass. 8 minus 1 is equal to 7. Are you clear what I say here? Suppose another example. There are 6 subjects. The result will be declared 2 to the power 6. In how many ways can a student fail? Minus 1. 2 to the power 6 means 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 8 to the 16, 16 to the 32, 32 to the 64. 64 minus 1, 63 ways. The person can be failed in 63 ways. Or there are 6 subjects. In how many times you will be failed in one subject? That is your 6C1 plus 6C2 in 2 subjects. How many times you will be failed? Plus 6C3 plus 6C4 plus 6C5 plus 6C6. This is 6C1, 6C2, 6C3, 6C4, 6C5 plus 6C6. That answer will be 2 to the power 6 minus 1. It is your 63. Clear? If you solve this question, 6C1 it is 6, then 6C2, 6 into 5 divided by 2, 5 3 15, then 6C3, 6 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 3 factorial, 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2, okay, divided by 3 factorial, 6 into 6, this 6 cancels, 5 4 20, 6C4 means 6 factorial divided by 4 factorial into 2 factorial. That means 6 into 5 divided by into 4 factorial divided by 4 factorial into 2 factorial. So here 4 factorial, 5 factorial cancels. 2 factorial means 2, 2, 3 is 5, 3 is 15. Okay. 6C5, it is plus 6. 6C1 plus 1. If you added this number, 15, 15, 30. 30 plus 20, 50. 50. Then 6, 1, 7, 6, 13. 50 plus 13. the answer is 63. Clear? Suppose I will give you one calculation. 4c1, it is 4. 4c3, it is also 4. 8c1, it is 8. Then 8c7, it is also 8. 100c100, 100c99, it is also 100. Clear? 100c1 is equal to 100. 100c99 is equal to 100. First calculation, it is your combination calculation. Then come to the second. Suppose 4c2. 4c2 means 4 into 3 divided by 2. 1000c2. I can write 1000 divided into 999 divided by 2. Clear? Another example for calculation in the combination. 10c9 plus 10c 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 1 plus 10c 9 plus 10c 8 plus 10c 7 plus 10c 6, okay, plus 10c 5 plus 10c 4 plus 10c 3 plus 10c 2 plus 10c 1. This answer is 2 to the power 10 minus 1. If you solve this question one by one in the combination formula, directly you can get also answer 2 to the power 10 minus 1. This calculation result will be this. 2 to the power 10 means 1024 minus 1, 1023. If you calculate 1 by 1, then you will get a final answer 1023. But you put this formula 2 to the power 10 minus 1, also you get 1023. Clear? Come to the next number. Question number 11. Sorry, question number 6. 6 finished. Question number 10 finished. Question number 11. On a new year day, every student of a class sends a card to every other student. The postman delivers 1190 cards. How many students are there in the class? In the case of a card, 2 into NC2 is equal to 1190. NC2 is equal to 1190. Then N into N minus 1190 by 2. Okay. N into N minus 1 by 2 is equal to 1190 by 2. This 2 cancels. N into N minus 1 is equal to 1190. So 35 into 34 is equal to 1190. Answer is 35. Option A is your correct answer. Clear? In the case of a card, in the case of a letter, two persons require to for one letter. But in the case of a letter, the person sends a letter and also gets a letter. That means two letters to, in the case of handshake, only one handshake possible for two persons. But in the case of letter, there are two letters also sent each other. But in the case of handshake, only one handshake will be get. So question number 12. In an examination, a minimum is to be secured in each of six subjects for a pass. In how many ways can a student fail? This question also repeat 2 to the power 6 minus 1. That means 63. The next number, question number 13. There are 8 questions in a question paper. In how many ways can a student solve one or more questions? 8 questions in a question paper. 8 questions in a question paper, 8C1 plus 8C2. One question will be solved, but here 2 questions will be solved. Then 8C3. Plus 8C4, plus 8C5, plus 8C6, plus 8C7, plus 8C8. You know that this is shortcut calculation is 2 to the power 8 minus 1. 2 to the power 8 means 2 2 4, 2 2 4, 4 2 8, 8 2 16. This is 16. And 16 to 32, 32 to 64, 64 to 128, 128 to 256. So that 256 minus 1, 255. Option D is your correct answer. Clear? Next number, question number 14. A badminton tournament consists of 2 matches. In how many ways can the result be forecast? That is your 2 to the power 5. 2 to the power 5 means 32. 2 2 जा 4, 4 2 जा 8, 8 2 जा 16, 16 2 जा 32. Option A is your correct answer. But in the case of a student can be fail. A student can be fail. So suppose there are three subjects. FT, reasoning and English. Okay. One student will be appear the exam. In how many ways a student can be fail? You know that 2 to the power of 3 minus 1. This in, that is 7. In the 7 ways a student can be fail. But in how many ways the result will be declared? That is your 2 to the power 3, 8 ways, which is discussed in this example. Again, I also discuss this example. Suppose mathematics and reasoning and English. There are three subjects. In how many ways the result will be declared? Suppose pass, pass, pass. Then fail, fail, fail. A student can be pass or can be fail. Then pass, fail, fail. Then pass, pass, fail. Then pass, fail, fail. Then pass, pass, fail. Clear? Then pass, pass, fail. Then fail, fail, pass. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 2 to the power of 3 is equal to 8. In this 8 ways, the result will be declared. From the result, the student will be passed for one time. Thus, fail for 7 times. Are you clear? So here, the student, if you appear the exam, there are three subjects. In how many ways the result will be declared? 2 to the power 3 is equal to 8. In one subject, he may be pass or he may be fail. There are two chances, I write here two. For the how many subjects here? Three subjects, 2 to the power 3. There are 8 ways the result will be declared. From the 8 ways, one way is the pass way, completely will be passed. The rest of the results are indicates to fail. There are 7 ways to fail. Clear? So here, 5 matches. In how many ways can the result be forecast? In one match, either win or loss. That is your 2 chances, 2 to the power 5. 2 to the power 5 means there are 32 ways. Option A is your correct answer. Clear? Question number 15. In how many ways 10 identical toys be placed in 3 distinct boxes such that no box is empty? Very important question. 10 identical toys. Suppose these are the toys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. These are the 10 toys. We keep all the toys in 3 different boxes, but no box is empty. But we have to keep at least 1 toy in a box. So here, now we divide 3 parts of these persons. In how many ways 10 identical toys be placed in 3 distinct boxes such that no box is empty? Suppose I write E, I divide in this ways. Okay. This is one group, this is one group, and this is one group, and this is one group. That means in the first box, only 1 person, in the second box, only 3 person, and the rest of the persons in third box. But we separate these 10 persons in other ways. Suppose in this way also, in this way also, many ways we can divide these 10 persons for the 3 boxes. Are you clear? So there are 10 persons. We can make the 2 lines among of these. 2 lines. There are 10. 1. So here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There are 9 places vacancy. We can select only 2 places for the lines. If you make 2 lines among these 10 persons, so you can get 3 parts of the persons. 3 different groups of the persons for the box, 3 boxes. Are you clear? So there are 9 places to make two lines to make two lines. Clear? So 9C2. 9C2 means 9 into 8 divided by 2. 2 4 ja 9 4 ja 36. So option D is your correct answer. Option D is your correct answer. Are you clear? If you have other doubt, then you can also meet in the doubt clearing class. Thank you very much. Bye.